I am worn out. I have been kind of walking around this morning and looking at different things with my binoculars, just walking around church, and I've been looking at something out there, and I've been looking and I'm kind of trying to focus in. It looks like maybe is it a fire hydrant? Let me look. Let me focus. Oh, it is not a fire hydrant. It is moving. It is moving. It is a goose. There is a goose out here. Let me look. Oh, I'm looking. Maybe he wants me to ask a really important question today. Okay. While he's coming. Here we go. We're going to go ahead and ask a question. We're going to ask it right now. And those of you who are out here right now, you know, that are in here, and those of you who are in your living room, here it comes. Here it comes. Get ready, because that goose is going to leave. Are you ready? Oh my goodness, that was amazing. Oh, I think those, let me just see. Oh, I'm focusing in. I think they're coming. Oh, as you can tell, we are going to talk this whole month about focusing in. And before we get started on this whole awesome theme, I want to focus in on birthdays. You know what I'm talking about. Miss Donna's going to throw me. Yes, if it is your birthday, if you had a birthday this past week, I have no idea. I am sweating from this big adventure. We are going to wish you a happy birthday. Get a hat, get anything you want, and say, it's my birthday. Praise the Lord that you were born this week. I am so excited for you. All right, see my birthday hat? I love it. I'm going to tell you guys, I'm getting kind of hungry. I mean, I've been doing this adventure, obviously looking at some geese, and I'm getting hungry, and I've been trying to eat healthy. I've been trying to eat healthy during this, really focused on my health. But today I'd like to have a cookie. I really would. Mr. Rick, I'd like you to come on up. There's some cookies. Miss Donna's going to grab you some cookies. I'm going to put my binoculars right here. Come on up on stage. Come on up. Mr. Rick's not going to say anything right now, but we're going to... You know, last month we were working out, and I keep rewarding him now with just cookies. Okay, so you can take this cookie. We're going to play a little game. Because, you know, the kids aren't really here, and we can't play a game, but we can do this. We can play a game. I want you to go stop the video, run into your kitchen, grab a cookie, a cracker, anything that's kind of circular. The bigger, the better. Ours is kind of small, so this challenge is going to be awesome. Okay, so Mr. Rick, here's what we do. You're not allowed to say anything either. This is, you got to focus. It's not going in your mouth that way. Okay. All right. What you're going to do is you can put this cookie. Some of y'all have done this a minute to win it. We're going to put this cookie. This is going to be quite, this may not even work. So it's just get a big cookie if you can. Okay. So what we're going to do when I say go, we're going to try to use our facial muscles, really focus. You may not even be able to see the cookie, but you got to trust that it's there. Okay. Trust that it's there. And we're going to wiggle it into our mouth. Okay. And when one falls, we've got a couple extras in here. Okay. Ready? You're terrible at this, Mr. Rick. Okay, are you ready? He's sweating too. Okay, ready? Go. Okay. I got another one. Okay. Hopefully you're doing this at home. Oh, I think I got it. Those of you who are out in the background, you can cheer for us. Oh, that is...
Mr. Rick,
listen, I'm going to give you all these, and you go focus and work on that. I won. I just want you all to know I've been sweating. Do I have cookie on my face?
You don't have cookie on your face. I think you need some water.
Oh, I think I do.
Here, have some water.
That was the famous Amos, straight from the church vending machine. I would like to tell you all the reason that worked for me is I'm sweaty for my adventure, and so the sweat actually contribute to that, and it really helped me focus. I hope you played that at home, and I hope you got a free cookie. You can say, Miss Sarah, let me eat a cookie this Sunday morning. You go for it, and let me know if you won that game. That was delicious. So obviously, guys, what we're focusing on is focus, and we are going to focus in on this awesome word called faith. And Mr. Greg is going to put up this scripture for me. We're going to learn a new scripture. And it's getting ready to come up, and I'm learning it as well with you guys. And it's in Acts 10. It's not that one. Let's see which one it is. This is just our typical. I was getting ready to read just what it said, Greg. I love it. It is the one in... Oh.
Hey, Kai, it's coming.
hey, this is how we are always interested. Well, anyway, I'm going to teach you. Let's first of all learn the word faith. Okay, so here is the word faith. It goes right here. I have got cookie crumbs all over me. This is fantastic. It goes right here, and then we bring this. So this is faith. That's it, Hebrews. I was getting ready to say Acts. I was like, I know it's in Hebrews. So I'm going to open my Bible. It's in Hebrews 11:1. Hebrews 11:1, and we are going to learn all about the word faith today. All right, so this is faith right here. So we come right here. So faith. And if you look at the screen, you'll see it. It says, faith is being sure. So let's do that again. Faith is being sure what we hope for. So this is hope. And we're going to learn a little bit about hope, too, what these words are. So let's do it again. Faith is being sure what we hope for. It is being sure. So think of this. It is being sure what we do not see. What we do not see. Kind of like the wind. I could really use some wind right now. I don't see it, but I can feel the wind and I can feel the effects of the wind. And we are going to learn in Scripture what faith really, really means. And this is what's so neat. There's one more slide for me, Mr. Greg. I love it. It kind of makes it like we're here. I love this. We're trying to figure out technology, make it happen. Oh, I got crumbs all over my face. The next one is this. I want you guys to know that you can know Jesus. You can know Jesus. Even though you can't see him, you can know him. And we're going to learn more about how can we know him without seeing him. I know Jesus. I haven't seen him, but I know he is there and he has changed my life. So stay tuned, guys. I want you to hold on, be all ready, focus in, and let's learn what faith really means.
Hey, everybody.
I'm Erica, and I'm so excited about it being summertime. One reason I'm so excited is because I have developed my very own STEAM lab! Look it, check it out. Isn't that so awesome? You're probably wondering what that stands for. Science, Technology, Engineering, Art, and Mathematics. And I'm not totally sure how things will go in my lab this summer, but luckily, I have faith. Faith is trusting in what you can't see because of what you can see. You see? You see what I did there? I have faith that I'll learn a lot and probably have fun doing so. I mean, just look at this place! Check it out.
Whoa!
Oh, wait. Perfect. Check out this microscope! Microscope. I've always been amazed how microscopes can let you see things that you normally can't see. Take hair, for instance. Ow. Look at that one. See, it looks like a thin line. Mine's kind of curly. Ooh, you can't see it, can you? But put it under a microscope.
Wow.
Cool, right? What about the inside of a piece of grass? Put it under a microscope. Whoa, look at that. The inside looks like a whole bunch of smiley face emojis. I mean, you never see that just by looking at grass. Today's Bible story is all about not being able to see everything, but remembering that God always does. It's like he's always looking through a microscope or something. So, let's take a look at this story and see what we can find. Unbelievable!
Is that really what my hair looks like?
Good morning, everyone. So happy to see you back here this week. Stand up with us, and we are going to sing a beautiful love story for our Savior.
Love letter in the sky. Church, I'm so happy to be here to talk to you about faith. Faith is so important. Faith changes the way we live our lives, the way we think about ourselves, the way we think about God, and about the way we treat others. Faith is sort of like these binoculars. We can look through and see everything in our life. It helps us to make sense of things, to know what to do when things get really hard. Our faith reminds us that we can trust God no matter what. Faith is being sure of what you hope for, and faith is being sure of what we don't see. That is what the people of long ago were praised for. You see, faith is believing in things you can't see because of things that you can see. We can't see God, but we can see what God gave us. We can see about the men and women who face tough times just like you and I do. People were hurting, they were scared, and they were overwhelmed. But they chose to believe and to follow God. They chose to trust His promise that one day He would send a rescuer. And that rescuer was God. That rescuer was Jesus. In today's story, you're going to learn about several people in the Bible who had a great deal of faith in God. Let's take a look.
The Bible. It's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how He created us and loves us so much made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. Now for an amazing story, inspired by the book of Hebrews, chapters 11 and 12.
Gotta have a little faith, 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 faith. Keep the faith. Take a leap of faith. You know, a lot of people toss around the word faith lately. We say you can break the faith or just take it all on blind faith. But true faith isn't blind at all. It's much more than just an inspirational word. True faith has to do with believing in all the things you can't see because you start with what you can see. Now, we can't see God with our physical eyes, but we can see the stories of people who came before us. They lived in a broken world like we do, but
they chose to follow God. They chose to trust his promise that one day he would send a rescuer that would make everything right again. The writer of Hebrews in the New Testament tells us about some of these men and women in God's story. People like Noah, people like Abraham.
Abraham.
When God called Abraham, he was already getting old. He and his wife Sarah didn't have kids.
Leave your country and your people. Leave your father's family. Go to the land I will show you. All nations on earth will be blessed because of you.
God was planning on sending his rescuer as one of Abraham's great, 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 etc. grandchildren. But still, even though Abraham had God's promise, he still couldn't see the one God was sending. Still, Abraham went on a wild adventure, following God's call. And even his descendants, Isaac, Jacob, and Joseph, all chose faith in God. Moses, too, was called by God from the fiery heart of a burning bush. Even though he was raised by Pharaoh's daughter, he chose to stand with his own people and face Pharaoh's anger to win freedom. We read about it like this in the book of Hebrews.
Moses suffered shame because of Christ. He thought it of great value.
See, when you check out Hebrews, you discover this huge list of people who followed God by faith, so many that the writer just stops trying to list all of them. Oh, but we can't forget Israel's most important king, David.
Get up and anoint him. This is the one.
Even though God had promised David would be king, though, David spent years on the run from King Saul, fearing for his life. Still, he chose to trust God.
The Lord is my shepherd. He gives me everything I need.
Now, none of these people in the Old Testament could see with their eyes how God was going to save his people, but they could see how he was working in their lives, how their needs were being met. So they chose to believe in his greater plan. They chose faith.
Faith is being sure of what we hope for. It is being sure of what we do not see. That is what the people of long ago were praised for.
Now, here's where the story turns. In Hebrews, we discover that none of those people in the Old Testament received what God had promised here on earth.
That's because God had planned something better for us, so they would only be made perfect together with us.
God's plan includes all of us from the very beginning of creation. So at just the right moment, at the perfect point in time, God sent his rescuer, the hero, his very own son, Jesus. Jesus showed us how to live. He showed us what God was like, and he told us the most important thing.
If you love one another, everyone will know you are my disciples.
Love God, love others. It's the heart of the whole story. But then, Jesus was killed, and his friends thought the story was finished. Period. Dot. The end. Until God raised him back to life. Jesus has defeated death, and those who follow him can live with him forever. But how do you follow someone you can't see? Well, that brings us back to faith.
Let us keep looking to Jesus. He is the one who started this journey of faith, and he is the one who completes this journey of faith. He paid no attention to the shame of the cross. He suffered there because of the joy he was looking forward to. So think about him. Then you won't lose hope.
The early believers, Peter and John and other followers of Jesus, had seen him teach and heal. They saw him after God raised him to life. But after Jesus returned to heaven, the believers continued to live by faith.
We have to speak about the things we've seen and heard.
Because of what the new Christians in the early church had seen, they could believe in what they could not yet see, the end of the story, where God makes everything right. They kept the faith, and because they did, we can choose faith too.
Woo! Take a look at this one. Any guesses on what that is? It's the inside of a carnation stem. It's amazing how things look so different under a microscope than they do just with our eyes. It makes me think of Hebrews chapter 11. It's where we can look back to all these people in history who had faith in God. Even though they couldn't always see how things would turn out, they believed God and His promises. They lived by faith. And you can live by faith too. In fact, having faith in Jesus and what He did for you on the cross is what makes it possible for you to have a relationship with God.
Relationship status update.
Even though we can't see Jesus in person, we can still have faith in Him because we can see how He's worked in the lives of the people who've come before us. That's the one thing to remember today. You can know Jesus even though you've never seen Him. If you want to know Jesus more and you don't know where to start, try talking with someone who has put their faith in Jesus. Or you can read the stories in the Bible of the people who trusted God long ago. There are lots of things we can see that can help us have faith. So, I hope you guys have an awesome day. I'm gonna look at a few more things under my microscope. Like maybe my nail. Ah, let's check it out. Oh, I need to wash my hands better. This microscope tells you a lot.
It's amazing to look back at all the people who believed in God and put their faith in Him. People like Abraham, Moses, and David. They trusted in what they couldn't see. They believed that God was faithful. They believed that God would keep His promises. They believed that it's always worth it to follow His plan. Remember, faith is being sure of what we don't see. I hope you guys are having a great start to your summer. We sure do miss you, and we look forward to seeing you real soon. Have a great week.
Oh, hey guys. Hey, I just want you to know, I have had these binoculars since I was about your age, maybe just a little bit older. So I wanted to bring my own today since we're talking about focusing and trying to see things that are hard to see sometimes. And sometimes if you are trying to see something far away, binoculars can help, or telescope. How about if you want to see something up close, maybe something really tiny? Maybe you need a microscope to see that, right? But you need sometimes to use different instruments to see things. And so today we're going to talk about how we can use God to focus on things. But before we start that, I just do want to tell you again that we miss you guys so much. It is not the same being here in this room without you guys. Lillian, I see you back there. I hope you're having a great summer. Allison, you too. Emma, we miss you guys. And Asher, I wish you could be here with us. I saw you out riding your bike yesterday out in the parking lot, though, so I hope you're having a great summer as well. Our verse today is Hebrews 11:1. I know Sarah talked about that earlier, but Hebrews 11:1 says, faith is being sure of what we hope for. It is being sure of what we do not see. You know, we all have to use our faith sometimes. We don't think about it, but we use our faith every day in different circumstances. How about maybe when you're sitting down? Whatever you're sitting on at home now, did you check that to see if it would hold you before you sat down? No, you just sat down because you had faith in that chair. How about when you're eating? I don't know what you had for breakfast, but did you do a taste test on that egg before you ate it? Did you do a poison test on your orange juice before you drank it? No, because you had faith that it was okay. How about the air that you're breathing? Do you do an air test on the air that you... No, because you trust it. You've done it so much that you trust it. But you know, there are times where it is hard to have faith. It is hard to have faith sometimes. Sometimes things don't work like you think they should, like this pandemic that we're in. It's a little bit different now. And so sometimes you do have to trust. You have to wear those masks when you go out in public. You wear gloves. You wash your hands a little more because things are different. But God never changes. Our bottom line says you can have Jesus even though you've never seen Him. You can have Jesus even though you've never seen Him. Well, how's that? We have never seen Jesus, but we see the things that Jesus has done. We read His Word and we trust what the Bible says about what Jesus did. And that's how we can trust Him. We don't see the wind, but we see the trees moving. We see leaves flying, but we don't see the wind, but we trust and we know it's there. If you study God's Word, it helps you with your faith. If you don't study His words, the other things I would encourage you to do is talk to people who do believe in God. Talk to maybe your mom and dad. Maybe you have a grandparent that has been in church and has known Jesus for a long time. Talk to them and find out what Jesus has done in their life. And that way you can have the faith and assurance that He'll do the same thing in yours. I know it's hard to talk to us now at church because you're not here, but when you get back, we would love to talk to you and share with you. I would love to share, just spend hours and tell you things that God's done in my life to help you with your faith. But before you can have that faith, you have to know Him. And so that's what I want to talk to you just for a second about, boys and girls. Do you know Jesus as your Savior? Have you ever asked Him to be your Savior? Have you ever said to Him, I know I'm a sinner, I believe You died on the cross for me, and ask Him to forgive you. Boys and girls, if you've never done that, I pray that today you would do that. So let's pray right now. Before we go any further, let's pray. And I want you to think about that. Think about that decision. Dear Jesus, we love You so much, and we are so thankful that the examples that You shared with us in Your Word of Your life and how You helped other people, and then they had faith in You. And I pray that we can have faith in You as well. And our faith will become stronger and stronger and stronger. But most of all, Father, I pray if there's a boy or girl out here today that doesn't know You as Savior, that today would be the day that they would say to You these three things. I know I'm a sinner. I believe You died on the cross for my sins. And I ask You to forgive me. The most important decision that they could ever make, Jesus. I pray that You would give them the wisdom and the courage to do that today. Father, we thank You for each one of these boys and girls. And we pray that You'll bring them back to us soon. These things we ask in Your most holy name. Amen. So, if you have made that decision today, I would love to hear about it. Send me an email. And you know, I haven't gotten many emails from you guys. I'm a little bit disappointed. I would love to get them. But send me an email right here. rick@life-community.com, especially if you made that decision today. But if not, if you've got questions that you want us to help you with, we'll be glad to do that. A question that will help you in your faith, we'd love to answer that. Or if you have a prayer request or a praise report, we'd love to hear about those too. So send me that email, and also continue to check studio252.tv. And there's a lot of things there that you can use in your walk with Jesus. Guys, we miss you. We love you. Stay focused. Stay focused on God. It's going to get better. It's already getting a little bit better. We're having church soon, so you'll be able to come back and be here in God's house. We love you. We thank you. See you soon. Bye-bye.
Let's do church clap, guys. Get out of here.
Coming back, clap up. When that whole week beat you up and stretch you, but you hear that organ playing and remind you of your blessings. And on another note, she just hit another note. Chills down my spine, got me crying, put me overload. You don't know about it though. Old school church hymns, deacons get the humming out of the drum. I'm finna burst in. Can you hear me now? Church close, sweaty, you don't care, you just get it now. Testify how we made martyrs out of these fathers and rose up all of his. Daughters to glorify Him with thunder. Man, it's West Simmons Jones with a head getting out. churches been clapping at weak sermons, leaving the weak hurt, that was changed by Sunday service. We need discernment, check what you be affirming, cause the church can be full of members but empty in conversion.